You know, it really just kind of all came together, really from the Lord. I got a song sent to me from Chris Tomlin and Matt Redman saying, hey, we just keep thinking about you with this song. We wanted to know if you wanted to finish writing on it. And right the same week, I had just booked the Majestic Theater in Dallas to record my live album. And so when they sent me the song, I looked at the title and it said, How Majestic. And I was like, whoa, God, you're up to something.
The moon and stars, they wept. The morning sun was dead. The Savior of the world was fallen. His body on the cross. His blood poured out for us. The weight of every curse upon him.
And so I knew he was up to a theme for this album of it just being about him, how he's the king, we worship the king, and he's mighty, he's majestic. And so really it just kind of all came together at the same time.
One final breath he gave, as heaven looked away, the Son of God was laid in darkness, a battle in the grave.
You know, when the presence of God is there and you feel him in the room, it just always, you just realize it's not about us, it's not about me being the worship leader, it's just about that he's moving and he's ministering to these hungry hearts that have come to worship. And so I love that. I love that my job is to just facilitate that and get it going and to just keep pointing people and their attention up to the Lord. And this song Forever is really erupting every night that we do it. People are getting this revelation of the cross in a whole new way, and it's just, it's really building people's faith. It's really exciting to watch. Idea what the next single will be. It was a surprise that they wanted to do Forever as the first one, which totally makes sense. I just am excited because I feel that all the songs on this album are really congregational, and there wasn't one song that I wasn't excited to do on the album. Each of them do something different, and there's some really exciting moments and then some really deep worshipful moments. And I would say I think one of my other favorites on the album is called I Am Not Alone. It might not be a single, but it'll be one I think that people really connect to, like they connect with You Are For Me. Because it's one that just, it's right out of Isaiah 43 where it says, you will walk through the water, you will walk through the fire, and all these things, but you will not be overtaken, and you will not be burned, you will not be overwhelmed. And I love that about the Lord because it's a promise from him that we will walk through stuff, but we will not be overwhelmed by it, and that in all of it, we're not alone, that he's with us. For me, listening to a lot of worship music always helps me connect and stay connected with just not getting too internal on my own stuff that I'm going through. And when I say stuff I'm going through, it's stuff anybody's going through, just trials and things and storms and stuff that God has us walking through to build our faith, and family stuff. I miss my family a lot, and so I listen to a lot of worship music. You know, we focus a lot about the cross. I mean, it always goes back to the cross. It always goes back to Jesus and the price he paid for us on the cross. And I love when they took him off of the cross and they were waiting for the promise to be fulfilled in those 3 days. He was in hell, taking over the enemy and defeating the enemy, taking the keys to death and hell and the grave, to rise again as the victor over the enemy. And I think sometimes we forget to celebrate that part as well, that the enemy has no power unless we give him power in our lives, unless we open doors. But Jesus has already paid the price for our victory, to be overcomers because of Jesus' blood. And so I believe that this song just really helps people to see that part of the cross and salvation, as well as the mercy and the grace, and that forever we'll glorify the name of Jesus in our worship.
Lift up our voice and praise.
When I first heard it, it was on a cassette tape. And I just thought, I don't know, I was young too, and I wanted a cool song, like they wanted me to sing this, and I thought, I don't know what I think about it. And they just said, listen differently, you know, we'll add different piano, it'll sound more up to date, I guess it would be a better word. And when I listened again, I just remembered feeling the presence of God so strong, thinking, oh my goodness, this is a really strong song. And it wasn't until the first time, though, of leading it in front of people and seeing how they were worshiping with it, that I really understood that it was a really strong and powerful worship song.